Hi, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the Givenchy Photo Perfection Foundation. I read so many good reviews on Sephora about this foundation, and I was a little curious and I wanted to see if it actually worked for my skin type. If you don't know or haven't watched any of my previous videos, my skin type is combination. I have a very, very, very oily T-zone and dry everywhere else. So I wanted to see if this foundation lived up to the hype. So if you want to see if this foundation is worth your hard-earned coin, then just keep on watching. I'll show you what it feels like now I'm on the outside. I'll show you what it feels like. So for primer, I use the Nivea Men Sensitive Cooling Post Shave Balm. Ever since Nikki's tutorials talked about this, I've been obsessed with it. Even though it has a manly scent to it, I feel as though the tackiness, it just helps my makeup stay on longer than any other primer I've tried as of yet. If you can tell by the title of this video, we are going to be trying out the Givenchy Photo Perfection Fluid Foundation with Sunscreen. This gives you 100% natural complexion, zero flaws. It has an SPF of 20, which is pretty decent. I got the shade 104, which is Perfect Cinnamon. I used the Shade Matcher on Sephora to find my match for this, and I used the comparison between the Makeup Forever matte velvet color that I use, and I compared it to this, so I'm hoping this is my color. I love the packaging. It seems a little small. How many fluids? 0.8 fluid ounces. Okay, it's not that much, and it was retailing for, I believe, $51. I'll leave the actual price on the screen somewhere in case I am lying or mistaken. The packaging is really cute. Ooh, the top has the typical Givenchy logo, and it has a shiny top, which you can really see fingerprints on. It's kind of driving me nuts. It has a pump, which is great. So we're gonna try this on. I'm gonna use my Pure Cosmetics Beauty Blender that I use for my Fenty concealer, and I'm going to use the round side. So I'm just gonna do a few pumps on the round side and apply it, and we're gonna see exactly how it works. And I'm gonna zoom you guys in also so you can see how it looks like while I'm putting it on. Okay, so now that we are up close and personal, hi. I'm gonna start off with two pumps, and we're gonna see if I need to do any more. So I definitely need maybe two more pumps so my forehead and my neck can be covered, but so far, yeah, two pumps was okay. I need a bit more. My head is rather large. This is the foundation all blended out. Pros first, and then we'll talk about the cons. The pros for this foundation: it really does give you a natural complexion, as it says. It was super easy to blend out. I feel like it matches my skin tone better than the matte velvet foundation that I have. It gives off a matte finish, but also kind of dewy. It's very interesting. It's a really nice finish. I have no complaints about that. Now the cons: it is a bit watery. That's not really, I guess, a con for some people, but for me, I just kind of like mine a little more on the creamier side. Also, I can still see redness peeking through. It doesn't really get rid of my flaws. My freckles are still very prominent on my face. It didn't really claim to be a full coverage, I don't think. Going up close, I don't see any cakiness. It doesn't really sink into my pores either. I really do like the finish. I think it's really nice. I'm gonna do another layer, and then we're gonna see how it looks. Hopefully it doesn't get too cakey, but so far I really do like it. This is a a second layer on. I really do like the finish. I feel like even with a second layer, it doesn't look cakey. I still kind of look as natural as you could say. I think now it's kind of losing more of natural and starting to look a little bit more made up. It hid the redness a little bit better. There's still redness peeking through, but it's not claiming to be a concealer, so it's very natural. And I still look glowy, which is great. Off camera, I'm gonna finish my face up and I'll let you guys know how the foundation worked as far as putting more products on top of it, if it moves at all, if it stays put, and the finish, see if I get oily within the next hour and a half that I take to do my face. So yeah, I will be right back. So I finished my face off camera and this is the finished result. I'm gonna zoom on in so you guys can see the foundation up close. Honestly, love this foundation. It's been, let me just check my cell phone. It's been exactly 2 hours since I first applied this foundation. My nose is running, no. Usually with really crappy foundations, my T-zone would have been oily and just completely off of my nose. Usually there, especially, the foundation rubs off. So far, it's looking really good. I don't see any oils peeking through. It doesn't look cakey at all. It held up really well with the concealer. Didn't move around when I blended it out. It stayed put. I actually didn't even have to set it. And yeah, I did well with powder. Really looks really flawless on my skin. My pores look great. I mean, I have no complaints right now. This is looking pretty good. So around 8 o'clock, I'm gonna come back and do the final test and we're gonna see how the foundation looks at that point. If it's great for everyday workday or if it's something that you should just kind of pass on, maybe do it for a special event. Actually, I do maybe have one con. And I think the one major con that I can think of is that you have to use multiple pumps to really cover your face, which, you know, for the price point, if I have to constantly use like 4 pumps to cover my face to get a nice even coat, that kind of puts me off a smidgen. Yeah, it's looking good. So I will be back and we'll see exactly how my face looks and I'll give you my final thoughts on the Givenchy Photo Perfection Foundation.
Hi everyone, I'm doing this kind of vlog style. I was going to put my stand up and everything, but I decided F it, let's just do it more realistic, more face to face, more personal. Upon first glance, I'm noticing that there is some separation right there, but that usually happens with all foundations. Eventually the oils just kind of break through and you can't see it unless I'm like, and how often will I be doing that, realistically? Around 5 p.m. is when I started to notice the oils on my nose start to come through. This one recently, maybe like within the last hour, and then my chin, maybe just like now, it's barely oily. Aside from that, it looks like I just applied it everywhere else. It doesn't look cakey, it doesn't look dry, it didn't cling to any dry patches, so I consider that a win. I think I may have found another favorite. I don't know, what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below if you think that this foundation looks, maybe I'll zoom in a little bit so you guys could see better. Hold on. So this is a real close-up of my skin. Let me know in the comments below what you think about this foundation. Is something that you guys are gonna run out and grab? Pros definitely outweigh the cons. The only con I can think of for this foundation is the price, along with how many pumps of product I need to cover my face. Those are the only two cons I can think of. Honestly, this foundation is going to be a heavy rotation in my collection, and I think I'm gonna wear it just the rest of this week, maybe even for my birthday. I don't know, I really like the finish, and I like the fact that it took about 5 hours before the oil started to come through. I really dig this. I think it's worth the $51, yeah. It's a steep price, and maybe like a once in a while thing. I really do like it. So let me know your thoughts below on this foundation. And what other foundations do you think I should pick up and try that you're just like, girl, I have combo skin, try this foundation, it is amazing. Let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this video and I will see you all on the next one. Bye. Well, the dope boys gon' feel her. Flow so sick, I need a healer. Fuck is my MAC concealer.